This video is going to discuss drugs that we commonly use as cardiologists to prevent patients from either forming clots within the arteries or clots within the heart or elsewhere in the body. There are a variety of drugs that we use. Patients oftentimes refer to all of these as blood thinners, but that's not a correct statement. Some of them actually are blood thinners, but others just stop platelets from sticking to each other. And there's a very important distinction between these. Aspirin is the most commonly used drug, and aspirin stops platelets from sticking to each other. For patients that have stents or patients that have bypass surgery, we oftentimes prescribe aspirin to prevent platelets from sticking to the wall of the stent. That's not a blood thinner. Other similar drugs like clopidogrel, Brilinta, or Effient oftentimes are used in addition to aspirin, especially in patients that have stents, because aspirin sometimes is insufficient as a single agent to prevent clots from forming inside the wall of a stent. Other drugs such as warfarin, which is also known as Coumadin, on TV people see ads for afib, which is short for atrial fibrillation, for drugs like Xarelto or Eliquis. Those drugs are referred to as blood thinners or anticoagulants. Anticoagulants are used to prevent blood from clotting on the inside of the heart, and those are the clots that tend to leave the heart and cause strokes. With atrial fibrillation, which is in a separate video, I describe the inside of the heart not to being a smooth surface, but an irregular surface with pockets on the inside. When people have irregular rhythms and chambers or specific areas of chambers don't squeeze, blood tends to pool in those chambers, and when blood pools, that can form a clot. And drugs such as warfarin or apixaban, which is Eliquis, oftentimes are used for these people to prevent them from having a clot form and in turn a stroke or clots leaving somewhere else into the body. Those drugs are not as helpful for people with coronary artery disease. So sometimes patients have a combination of both atrial fibrillation and the stent, and those people most of the time need two different drugs, not just one drug to treat their condition. The problem with all of these drugs are they all increase the risk of bleeding to a various extent. Aspirin 20 to 30 years ago was prescribed to most people middle-aged or over that had risk factors for heart disease. And what we learned over decades is that it does increase the risk of bleeding from the GI tract. And that risk is higher in some patients than the benefit they get from lowering the risk of a cardiac event. Therefore, we realized the only people that really should be taking aspirin are ones that have either established coronary disease or many risk factors for coronary disease, and that risk is high enough to warrant the use of aspirin. The downside of this is when the news media picks up that we shouldn't be prescribing aspirin to everybody, unfortunately the story doesn't always get told correctly, and patients think they shouldn't take aspirin and they stop taking aspirin when they need to. For example, if someone has two stents that were put in 3 months ago, news media comes out and says you should stop aspirin, they stop taking aspirin. Those are not the patients that should be stopping aspirin, and each time the news media has picked up on something like this, there's a significant increase in the risk of heart attack and stroke for several months after these stories come out from patients inappropriately stopping their medications. So if you hear something like this and you're not sure if you should be taking your medicine, don't stop it and speak to one of your physicians, whether it's your primary care physician or your cardiologist, before discontinuing the medication. As far as blood thinners, another misconception, and unfortunately on the TV ads, I think that's what spurs a misconception. Patients are afraid to start it because on TV it says if you stop taking the drug, it increases your risk of a stroke. Stopping drugs like Xarelto or Eliquis does not increase your risk of having a stroke. Your risk is higher being off of the drug. The risk is not higher because the drug is stopped. For example, if you take the drug for 9 months and then you stop it, your risk of stroke subsequently going forward is much higher than it was during the 9 months that you were taking the drug. If you never took the drug in the first place, your risk of stroke would be higher, just as it would be starting at month 9 after you stop taking the drug. So patients shouldn't be afraid to take the drug for fear that if they stop it, they'll have a stroke. If they don't take the drug, that's the same risk as stopping the drug and having a stroke. Oftentimes patients have more than one problem. They'll have atrial fibrillation and they have a stent put in their arteries, and they'll be on two or sometimes three of these drugs for a short period of time or a longer period of time. And unfortunately, drugs like clopidogrel or prasugrel, which are for stents, are not good enough for preventing clots from forming inside the heart from rhythm problems like atrial fibrillation, and vice versa. The drugs that prevent clots from forming inside the heart for atrial fibrillation are not so good at preventing platelets from sticking to the wall of a stent and then in turn forming a clot inside the artery. So we will use combinations of these drugs in patients if they need to be on more than one drug. But if you are on more than one drug and you're not sure, once again, if you should be taking it or a different physician just added another drug to what you're taking, the next time you see your physician, make sure you bring your entire medication list, have them look at it, and ask them for a reason as to why you're on each of the specific drugs. And if there's a good reason, great. If there's no good reason, then hopefully they'll take you off medication that's not necessary. I've had the great fortune for many years of working with a great group of vascular medicine physicians. One of my former partners' name is Joseph Caprini. His link to his website is below. Dr. Caprini is the Dr. Caprini of the Caprini score, which is used by more hospitals than any other scoring system in the world to assess people's clotting risk when they're in the hospital for procedures or for other medical conditions. Dr. Caprini and I will be venturing forward producing more videos together, but I encourage people who are watching this video to go to Dr. Caprini's site. He has some very good information. He knows much more about this than I do, as this is his primary specialty. If you have questions, feel free to reach out to either one of us, and we'd be glad to answer questions anytime. I hope you have a good day.